Hey, what's going on, everyone? Today we are checking out a new feature from Managed Service for Apache Flink called in-place version upgrades. So what this means is if you're currently running an Apache Flink application with an older version of Apache Flink like 1.8 or 1.11, you can now upgrade those applications to a later version of Apache Flink like 1.15 or 1.18, and you can do so statefully. So let's look at what this looks like in the command line, and we'll take a look at all of the different edge cases that you might encounter when upgrading, so you know the best way to do this for your applications. So I'm gonna start by setting some environment variables just to make the examples a little bit easier to read. And then I'm gonna create an Apache Flink application with version 1.15. And let's take a look at this command just for a second. You can see that I have the runtime environment set to 1.15, and I'm referencing the jar that I created for Apache Flink 1.15. So I'm going to run this, and then I should be able to get the status of the application. Actually, I should be able to see it in the console. So let's take a look at it in the console. We can see the application was created and it's now in ready state. So I'm going to go ahead and start the application. And once this is started up, I'll walk you through what it looks like when we upgrade. So I'll pause the video here, and when the application starts, we'll take a look at what it looks like to upgrade the Apache Flink version. Okay, so now the application has started. We can see the banner at the top. And let me expand this just to make it a little bit bigger. We can see the application is running. It's using Apache Flink version 1.15. And we can see all of the metrics down here. So now I want to draw attention back to the console where we're going to call the upgrade application API. Let's say this application has been running for some time now, and we've decided that we're ready to upgrade to version 1.18 to make use of some of the new features in that Apache Flink version. So the one thing I want to call out here is what's new in the API, and that is this application configuration update field. So you can now pass in a new bucket arn, so a new location for your application jar and the new file key. Again, this application is relatively simple. It's just reading from a Kinesis data stream and writing to another one. But for illustrative purposes, we're going to upgrade this to a 1.18 version. So I just pressed enter, and we should now see, after some time, the application state go into updating. And I can actually call the API here. And we can see that it is now updating. So what's going to happen here is the update API is now going to take an application snapshot of your running application, stop the application from processing data, and then it's going to restore a new version of the application running on Apache Flink 1.18 with that snapshot that was taken in the previous application version. So once this starts up, we'll take a look at the Flink dashboard and show you just what that upgrade looks like. I also wanted to call out, and we'll show a demo of this later in the presentation, that at any time during the updating status, you can go here to Actions and click on Rollback to Previous Running Version. In case any issues arise, this gives you the option to roll back to your application in the previous version. Okay, so the update process has completed, but I want to point out a few key things. The first thing is we do have the Apache Flink runtime set to 1.18. I never stopped the application. This was a running application that we did an in-place upgrade to. And let's take a look at our snapshots. We can see that a snapshot was automatically taken when we called the update API. And if we come to the Flink dashboard, we'll see the running application. And I can also draw your attention to the fact that we have restored that checkpoint or that snapshot. This shows us that we were able to take a running application, take that snapshot, and then restore from that snapshot in the new Apache Flink version 1.18 with our new code. So that is what the upgrade API looks like. But I want to show you what could happen if you're upgrading to an incompatible version or if your state is incompatible between versions. Okay, so now I want to try looking at a new scenario. We have a new application here running Apache Flink version 1.8. And I'd like to upgrade this application to Apache Flink version 1.18. But to do so, I know that there would be some version incompatibilities between snapshots. And so there would likely be some issues if I actually tried to do this upgrade. But just to illustrate, I want to showcase what would happen. So first I'm going to create a snapshot here and we'll just call this my upgrade snapshot. Let's create that snapshot. And then I'm going to call the command to upgrade this Apache Flink version to 1.18. And now what we should see in the console, if I refresh here, we should see the status change to updating. Now, because I don't want to have any issues in my application, I'm going to say, okay, actually, I don't want to upgrade. I want to roll back to the previous running version. So I'm going to select that, and I'm going to say the application will stop updating. Application state will be rolled back. Okay, that's exactly what I want. So I'm going to click rollback. And now we can see the application rolling back. It already changed runtime versions back to Apache Flink version 1.8. And once this starts up, we should expect it to resume processing data as expected. Okay, so the application has successfully rolled back and it has transitioned back into running in the Apache Flink version 1.8. But suppose we allowed that upgrade to happen and we just let the process take place. Let's take a look at what would happen if we actually upgraded all the way from version 1.8 to 1.18 with that connector incompatibility. And I'll show you what you can do if that happens. So now we have the application upgraded from Apache Flink version 1.8 to 1.18. And it says status running, but if we take a look at the Apache Flink dashboard, we will see that the application failed. And I know this is because the snapshot was incompatible. So what can you do in this scenario? Well, we can actually just downgrade back using that same update application API back to version 1.8. And now the application will essentially downgrade from Apache Flink version 1.18 to Apache Flink 1.8 using the existing snapshot that we had. So we can see it's back in updating status and we are transitioning back to our previous snapshot that we took earlier during the upgrade application process. So now the application has successfully upgraded or downgraded back to the previous running Apache Flink version, Apache Flink version 1.8. We can go in and check that everything is good. And we can see the application is running. Everything is fine as expected. And now we can safely resume processing our data. So we covered a lot in today's demo. We looked at what a successful upgrade looks like. We also took a look at what could happen if you don't test your application compatibility If you're upgrading, you always have the opportunity to roll back while the application is upgrading. And you can also roll back after, even if your application fails to start. Just make sure that you take those snapshots that you have in order to recover your application state. My name is Jeremy Burr. I hope this was informative. Let me know if you have any questions in the comments. I know the first question is going to be, can we get access to the commands you are running in this demo? And yes, I will post them in the description with a link to the GitHub repo where you can access these snippets. Thanks for watching and have a great day.